Hey, shalom, Markings, Rakama Kapash from GMS London, giving all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Chachadash. Want to give double honors unto the elders, the apostles of GMS, and shalom out there to the whole four that pushing this truth and all sincerity. Back again with another video. I'm going to call this video Bitter Waters, man. You know, in the scriptures, you know, it speaks about, you know, bitter waters, man, in Book of Revelation. Where did I put it? I must have deleted it by accident. Right, let's put it back in. Right, and Revelation chapter 8 verse 11 says, and the name, let me start from verse 10, right? It says, and the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp, and it fell upon the third part of the rivers, and upon the fountains of waters, right? And this is talking about the, you know, the missiles and that, you know, these, this nuclear, you know, radiation and stuff like that, you know. And it says, and the name of the star is called Wormwood, and the third part of the waters became wormwood, and many men died of the waters because they were made bitter, right? Meaning they were contaminated, they were polluted, right? And so people were getting sick and dying, right, from this radiation. Well, you know, similar things happening now, right? Or, you know, it's kind of like building up towards that. And this is why everyone, or you know, part of the reason, right? Everyone's so goddamn ill, man. So sick, diseased, right? And there's been a lot of these incidences happening, conveniently, right? Back to back, and it's, you know, a lot of stuff seems to be happening recently with spills and whatever, right? So we're just going to look at a couple of these, a few of these articles, and that's been going on recently, because the water, people's water supplies, you know, as I mentioned some of these, right, in Philadelphia, right, they're trying to convince the public that, you know, all these chemical spills and train derailments, you know, unleashing chemicals in the air, and that they're fine, that there's nothing to worry about. Okay, when really, you know, these people are being made sick. Right, there's children coughing up blood and shit in places, man. Alright, so we know, you know, what happened in East Palestine. It's got here. So I live in near East Palestine, chemical spill. Officials who say we are safe are lying. Right, it's an article from The Guardian. Right, so that was that train derailment. Kind of like the first, I think it was like the first major one that was, well, I would say, was in the news. They're not really covering it. They're not covering all these spills and these, you know, these instances that are happening, man. So they're really not trying to make it too big of an issue, but, you know, it's being covered at least. So, you know, we get to put it out there, right? It says, so yeah, they don't believe they're safe at all. They're breathing in all these toxins, you know, all these chemicals that are being released from, you know, from these chemicals, right? And it's having an adverse effect on people's health, right? Let's have a look, see what it's got in here. I ain't seen none of these articles here, so let's have a look. Let's see what he's experiencing. So yeah, 11 cars of toxic chemicals derailed. Another 12 cars were damaged by fire. The train spilled cargo included vinyl chloride, a chemical that causes liver cancer. All right. Says people in the immediate area of the derailment were ordered to evacuate in case of an explosion. The rest of us were told to shelter in place. By Saturday next morning, the air was full of smog. I was supposed to take my girls to a school basketball game. I told them to put their hoodies up over their mouths. On Sunday, the EPA officials, Environmental Protection Agency or whatever it is, said that they did not detect any contaminants in the air. Like, how many people really believe that? You know, you're being told that nothing's wrong, that everything is completely safe, 100% safe, like nothing wrong at all here, nothing to see here, you know, move on. How many people really believe that? Right, it says, but my granddaughters had developed blotches all over their bodies. So we called it, you know, they looked like burns. Right, as if they had spent too much time next to a sun lamp. My 7-year-old granddaughter's leg was beet red. They were coughing and their eyes were burning. I began to experience constant headaches and a nagging cough. My cousin's wife is a cancer researcher at Stanford. She called us and said, get the girls the hell out of there. The railroad company had given us a voucher for 2 nights at a hotel. So we drove to an inn about 15 miles away. That's that conversation, right? On February 6th, officials decided to burn off the vinyl core rather than risk it exploding. The EPA said that there was a small uptick in toxins near the burn site and that it was to be expected. Dead fish started turning up in the streams. Bit of waters, man. Okay? A bit of waters is occurring, you know? Obviously, this is talking about, you know, in a bit of a later time, man. But, you know, you people are drinking bitter waters now, man. That's why you're getting ill. It's why, you know, you're diseased and sick. And no matter what you do with your diet, okay, you're still sick. You're still diseased. You know? I'll read verse 11 again. Oh, yeah. And the name of the star is called Wormwood, okay, which means bitter. Right, and the third part of the waters became wormwood, and men died of the waters because they were made bitter. Right, they were contaminated. That's why the fish are dying. You know, even verse 9, it says it up here. It says, and the third part of the creatures were in the sea and had life died. And the third part of the ships were destroyed. All right. So, you know, like I said, this is talking about, you know, all that. Missile radiation and that, but like I say, it's already started to occur. Man, we've already seen, you know, swarves of sea creatures, you know, beach up, you know, all dead up on the shore, man. You know, we've already seen that sort of stuff happen already, man. And it's because this world is being polluted by Esau and these companies and these so-called incidents, you know, accidents. You know, all the like the Fukushima, Chernobyl, what else, these oil spills. There's been more oil spills recently, man. It just seems like there's a lot happening environmentally, you know, that's affecting the ecosystem, man. You know, and so you got these chemical spills and whatever. Okay, so the EPA says testing showed that the air and water were safe. We didn't trust that assessment. Part of my family went to a relative's house in West Virginia. Each time I've gone to East Palestine to check on my house, my head starts aching again. Okay, it says, now it's been 6 weeks since the wreck. I dread nighttime because when I lie down to sleep, the constant coughing starts. My wife of 35 years woke me up recently because my breathing was so bad. She said I sounded like I had fluid in my lungs. Other people are having similar experiences. The ER doctors say it is chemical bronchitis. I've lost 15 pounds due to stress and anxiety. In addition to all the unexpected expenses, I'm paying for a home that I do not live in. And I don't know yet whether insurance will help. They've been saying that they don't cover chemical spills, right? Other people are even less lucky. They can't afford to leave. Our friend's sons keeps having nosebleeds. Before the rain, I was happy. I was a happy grandfather who got to see my granddaughters every day at my house. Now my family is split all over the place and living out of suitcases. Every day we struggle to with online schooling. The girls are desperate for a life to get back to how it used to be. Blah, 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 blah. All right, so they're not telling the truth. They're saying everything's fine and evidently it's not. You know? And like I said, there's been a lot of these events taking place recently. So people are getting effed all over the place. And they're health is at risk, right? So that's, you know, that's what happened in East Palestine. We got the one in Philadelphia, okay? And they're trying to convince you the water's safe to drink. It's strange that recently all these derailments and stuff has started happening, as if by coincidence, you know? So I know the elder brother, Yashawamba, was covering this in one of his recent videos. I was listening to that today. Yeah, so Philadelphia, this one from The Guardian a month ago, right? It says, it revealed the US is averaging one chemical accident every 2 days. Like, this, what kind of madness is this? Right? It says, The Guardian and analysis of data in light of Ohio train derailment shows accidental releases are happening consistently. Bro, this is staged. You know what I'm saying? This is staged, man. This ain't accident, coincidence, and all this dense. No, it's on purpose, man. All right. Like I said, the 10 year thing is fine. Okay, something ain't right. Okay. Let's see what else is here. Chemical leak in the pool. Alright. So, you know, I've had that stuff going on. I've got a couple more tabs here. Right, I've got oil spills here in the UK. Bristol and Philly, I'm guessing that's in America as well then. So a Bristol plant that spilled chemicals into Philly's water supply had other mishaps over the last decade. You know? And this is destroying people, man. But like I said, they keep wanting you to believe that you ain't gonna worry about none of this, man. This ain't affecting you in any way. This is part of Esau's Depop, man. Depop agenda. You know? Just to have a sick and dying population. You know? Right, let's have a look. So we got oil spills as well going on. I see here, you got one in the UK here. So an oil spill incident just occurred at the largest offshore oil field in Western Europe, but it wasn't the first pollution incident at the site, and it likely won't be the last. Fossil fuel company Perenco spilled 200 barrels of reservoir fluid into a natural harbour at which farm in south of England. All right, let's see. So maybe they had the BP one in off the coast of America, and they were spraying all that Corexit to get rid of the oil or whatever. Man, as if that didn't have a negative impact. All right, you got this incident or this problem. It's quagmire in Yemen at the moment with this tanker that's degrading and is about to sink or whatever. And it's got like, I need to find that article again. Where is it? How many barrels of oil in it? Like millions of barrels of oil. I wanted to get the numeration right. Millions of barrels of oil. Right, so the other article we just read in the UK was like hundred or whatever, and this is like a million barrels of oil that's waiting to be just to fall into the sea, you know. And you got the UN trying to buy it, or I think they bought a ship to try and then offload the oil off that one onto that one, you know. It's crazy, man. So super tanker anchored off Yemen's coast may explode at any moment, you know, and that's in the Red Sea. And you know, water moves, man. You know what I mean? The ocean is a living water, man. It moves and currents and all that kind of stuff. And all this is spread around the whole world. You know, it affects everybody. And like I said, all the nuclear power plants that have failed and leaked into the ocean, and all of this is making people sick, man. And this is Esau. This is Esau's doing, man. All Esau's doing. All right. So we got this in 2 Ezra chapter 15, where it says, "For wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled." Right. Shall I read off a bit? It's on 5, right? "Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction." Right. Only all this is the agenda of the Heavenly Father, man. Like, none of this is happening by accident. And, you know, ultimately, the Most High is the one behind it, or even though he's using these devils to create all these crazy-ass accidents or whatever, right? "So for wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, which they profanely commit. neither will I suffer them in those things in which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me, and the souls of the just complain continually. Okay, that's the elect, that's the righteous men of the Lord, right? We complain in this hell society, you know. And therefore saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt, okay, which is modern day America, right? That is the land of our captivity, the land of our bondage, right? So I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before, right? All these things that happened are part of those plagues, like all the water being, you know, polluted and diseased, right, affecting the people, making them sick and diseased, right, causing them to perish. That's the Lord bringing the plagues, man. Right, so Egypt shall mourn, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and punishment that God should bring upon it. All right. It's Micah chapter 2, verse 10, right? It says, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest, because it is polluted. It shall destroy you. And everything about this world is polluted. You know? Everything that we are living on, you know, following, you know, the philosophies, the you know, the religions, the food, everything's polluted. We're polluted because of it. You know? This place will destroy us, man. Right, so with the Lord is telling us to depart, return to the Lord. All right, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest. This kingdom wasn't made for us to, you know, enjoy and set up shop here. Right, our kingdom, our rulership is to come after this one. All right, so we should be focusing on the kingdom. All right, and doing what's right by the Heavenly Father. Right, so it shall destroy you even with a sword destruction. Right? And like I said, that's why our people are all messed up, man. You know, got 1,001 problems in the flesh, you know, in the minds, you know. Ezekiel 4 and 13 says, and the Lord said, even thus shall the children of Israel eat their defiled bread among the Gentiles, whither I have driven them. Like all that food, like I said, all this water, right, it's all in the food. Okay, it's in the ground that grows the food, right? So it's all in the food. It's in the fish, you know, that you fish out of the water. Right, everything is like I said, making us sick ultimately. Right, these bitter waters, man. Okay, and there's more to come, obviously. You know, like I say you ain't even gonna be able to. Like, no, you people might be taking a risk now drinking this water that these men are saying it's okay to drink. You know? You know, they're saying it's okay to drink the water. And you might be risking that, but, you know, you damn sure ain't going to be drinking none of that water when, in that Revelation prophecy is fulfilled, man. Okay, when that star Wormwood hits. Yeah, people are going to be dying. You can't drink that water. That's why, people are going to try, and a lot of people are going to die from that, you know. Alright. It's from Deuteronomy 28, verse 59. It says, then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful, and the plagues of thy seed, even great plagues, and of a long continuance, and sore sickness, and of long continuance, right? So this is part of our curses that we're facing in Egypt, in modern day Egypt. The Lord's doing this again, like he said he was. You know? He's gonna say he's gonna bring the plagues to Egypt again. All right, did I read that? I thought I read that. 15 and 11. know if I didn't. It's 2 Kings 15 verse 11. But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before and will destroy all the land thereof. Okay, so that's what the Most High is doing right now, right? Egypt shall mourn and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and punishment that God shall bring upon it. All right. So here in Deuteronomy 28, 59, it says, the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful and the plagues of thy seed, even great plagues and of long continuance and a sore sickness and of long continuance. Moreover, he will bring upon thee all the diseases of Egypt, which thou was afraid of, and they shall cleave to thee. Right? So this is what the Lord was going to do if we went off. And obviously we did, you know, and we're in the land of captivity again, you know, new Egypt, right? And our people are suffering from all these types of illnesses and sicknesses. You know, and it's no surprise when you got Esau, right? You know, contaminating the air, contaminating the water, the food, all of it. It's not a surprise. That's how the Lord's getting us, man, through this devil. You know, it says, 61 says, also every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, then will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed. All right. We all close up with this. Revelation chapter 11, verse 18. Before I get that, actually, let me see if there's this. I covered those. The same one. So yeah, it's one in North Dakota. It's just strange. It's all, you know, just consistently, man. Recently, there's just lots of derailments and all kinds of things like this, man. Pearl Harbor. Yeah, Pearl Harbor here in the UK, another one. Yeah, it says that 200 barrels, it was a relatively small spill, but was leaking into the shallow coast. The shallow coast close to the environmentally sensitive areas. He said it had the potential to cause substantive damage before it dispersed and broke down. Okay, so this is the same Perenco one. Yeah. All right, but yeah, you know, like I said, it's creating bitter waters, man. All right, so we're going to close out with the scripture. Revelation chapter 11, verse 18. So, and the nations were angry. And the people are angry. You know, people are getting fed up with this place, man. The nations were angry, and thy wrath is come, and the time of the dead, that they should be judged, that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants, the prophets, and to the saints, and them that fear thy name, small and great, and shouldest destroy them which destroy the earth. And so, like I said, Esau right here, creating all kinds of problems and destruction and death in the earth, man. You know, of all this crap that he put in the air, putting in the water, putting in food, you know, and saying polluting the minds of the people also. Right? He's just destroying everything, man. He's a destroyer. Right? And that's why he needs to be destroyed, man. Okay, to erase all of that. All right? But yeah, I thought I'd just cover these, a couple of those articles or whatever, and just to show you what's going on. All right, so Lord willing, this was edifying, and I'll catch you, brothers and sisters, on the next video, man. So, till next time, I say shalom.